Let's look at another way in which opera represents a human reality. Mozart seizes on a tiny possibility in the story, a point where Giovanni is giving instructions to his servant about a party, to build up a remarkable picture of his sexual power, excitement, and energy. And here's Tom Allen, who's going to sing it through for us in a moment. Just give us a taste of it first, Tom, just the opening few phrases.
Finch dal vino, calda la testa, una gran festa fa preparar. Se trovi piazza qualche ragazza, te con quella cerco menar. Te con quella cerco menar, cerco menar, cerco menar.
Wonderful tune, isn't it? How does it help you play, Giovanni? What's the point of the tune?
Well, it's one of the first sights that you have of this kind of manic concentration that there is in the man. It's rather frightening when it comes up because it makes tremendous demands.
It's actually frightening to sing as well.
Yeah, it is. Oh, absolutely. There's no question of that. It's a very, very demanding piece of music.
It goes on and on all the way without stopping.
Because, that's right. There's hardly time to breathe in it. You know, you have to cheat certain places, that otherwise you just you fall by the wayside.
There's also phrases that begin just before the beat, aren't there? That's right.
Yes, you anticipate certain things, and there's this unnatural emphasis at times. The wonderful thing about it is that for me anyhow, the way I like to think of it is that because of the great demands it makes physically on you, that you can interpret this, if you like, in one way and make it your mental approach to it. So it becomes a very great piece of concentration. The fact that I'm going to get this party ready. Go and get this party ready. Mm-hmm. Make ready the wine, get all the girls you can. And because of this concentration that then goes on, it's enormously helpful to be stood still on stage instead of flashing around.
That's very interesting.
That's the way I work it, you see.
So actually, well, that's very clever of Mozart, actually, because he wants you to be absolutely concentrated on, in fact, what the audience are going to see, because they will see this very concentrated figure.
That's right.
He's made the music extremely difficult, so that he will get you to put all your powers of concentration.
That's one way of doing it. I mean, there is another way of playing it very lightly and just throwing it off. That is very difficult, because as soon as that music starts, you're immediately caught up in it, and there's an enormous pulse in it. That's the big thing. It's the life force of Giovanni that is seen through
it. You couldn't really just throw it off, could you? Because it's actually rather loud. The orchestra goes...
It's very demanding.
The horns play all the way through, don't they? Mm. And there's also, I mean, there are, apart from that little syncopation we mentioned earlier, there's also little snarls and little... There's a little point where you go...
That's right.
It's supposed to be, but in fact you can't do a little trill.
No, it sounds like a rather delicate minuet or something, a dance movement.
But at that speed, of course, it comes out like a sort of snarl.
Yes, indeed.
Just give us that little bit.
That's how it comes out.
It's sort of very animal.
That's right. It's the animality in the man that comes through it. It's the savagery in his approach to this thing. That's the thing that excites me about it and the thing that makes it work, I think. Known as the champagne aria because, I mean, it deals with the subject of wine for the party, etc., etc., but it actually bubbles like champagne and it goes off.
But it's actually a much more vicious thing than one thinks of as champagne, isn't it? A much more animal, bestial.
Yes, it is, yes. I mean, I think it says something about his approach to women and his success with them.
A rather chauvinistic remark.
Yes, indeed, yes.
To end on.
I apologise.
Thomas Allen, thank you very much. You see how useful this aria is as a way of helping us to understand Giovanni's nature. It shows him acting positively at last. Generally, in this opera, he's caught in situations of other people's making. And it's also a brilliant extrapolation of an excited manner of speech. In the opera, by the way, it also comes between two slow tunes, so its effect is even stronger in context. And it's a more or less plausible way of delivering instructions, though perhaps rather crazily over the top. But that itself is no bad indication of the state of mind of a man who will be in hell by supper time.
Bravo, bravo, arci bravo, l'affar non può andar meglio. Incominciasti, io saprò terminar. Troppo mi premono queste contadinotte. Le voglio divertir finché vien notte. Finta da vino, calda la testa, una festa fa preparar. Se trovi in piazza qualche ragazza, te con quella cerco menar. Te con quella cerco menar, cerco menar, cerco menar. Senza che l'orge, la fantasia, dimmi duetto, chi la follia, chi la nanana, farà velar, dimmi duetto, farà velar, chi la follia, farà velar, chi la nanana, farà velar, e di fratanto dall'altra canto, con questa mandolina, una decina devi aumentar. Alla violista, una decina devi aumentar. Se trovi in piazza qualche ragazza, che con quella cerca meno. Alla violista, un mandolina, una decina devi aumentar. Senza canone, la danza sia, di minuetto, di la folia, di la lavanna, fare meno. Una da Cina, devi aumentar, una da Cina, devi aumentar, una da Cina, devi aumentar, devi aumentar, devi aumentar.